Hello teachers, I am Pradnya from Science Activity Center, ISAR Pune. Today I am here to discuss a very interesting topic which students learn in their 5th class. We have tried to make the lesson very interactive by using some hands-on activity to explain the concept better. In this video, I will share some of them to teach the topic phases of moon. I am a sphere, Earth natural satellite, always reflecting sun's bright light. You can see me on clear night, but I will keep changing my shape ever so slight. Can you guess who I am? By encouraging students to answer this puzzle, you can introduce the topic in the class. In their previous classes, students have learned about how the Earth rotates around its own axis and revolves around the sun. Also, how the moon rotates around the earth. So even though they know this, it is difficult for them to visualize. So let's start with an interesting activity. And you will need a torch and a pencil. Project the torch on the wall of the classroom and place a pencil in front of the torch and observe the shadow formed by the pencil. Instead of pencil, you can also place your hands with various gesture to form the shadows of rabbit, dog, bird, fish, etc. and ask the student to identify them. This is really a fun activity and nice way to hook the student's attention towards the topic. Let's start our next activity. For this, you will require a ball and a cycle spoke or a stick. Take the students outside the class in the open space where the moon is slightly visible, mostly in the morning. Insert the bicycle spoke or a stick into the ball about a half away through its diameter. Hold this assembly upright such that we can observe the moon and the ball simultaneously. Observe the shadow formation on the ball while keeping the ball as a reference as you see here. Now you can ask the following questions to the students. What do you observe? How much portion of a ball is actually bright and how much is dark? Why do you think a certain part of a ball is dark and rest of it is bright? You can have a discussion on the responses given by the students. Students would really have fun doing this activity as this activity gives them chance to go outside the classroom. This leads us to our next activity. For this, we will need a printed card sheet of a phases of moon, press button, glue, scissors, and ice cream stick. First, cut two circles out of a thick card sheet. The marking on the circles should be as seen here. The slits of a rectangle and circle are cut and a hole is made at the center of both card sheets. Cut an ice cream stick in half and glue it vertically to its circles. Insert the part of press button in a top card sheet and other part in a bottom card sheet. Snap the press button to join the two card sheets with their printed sides facing you. Using the ice cream sticks as a handle, rotate one circle counterclockwise and observe the rectangle and circular slits. You will find the shape of a moon at the corresponding number of days from a new moon. At this point, you can introduce names of the phases like gibbous, crescent, full moon, new moon, waning, waxing, and a sequence of the phases. In my experience, this is where a lot of students get confused. This toy really helps them to understand the concept well and in interesting way. You can also ask students to play a small game where one student actually tells the name of the phase or number of days and other student draw the shape of the moon. Our next activity is to demonstrate how the movements of the sun, earth, and moon result in the phases of the moon. The bulb acts as the sun and the ball acts at the moon. We are like the earth. As you can see, the current position is a new moon and make the moon orbit around us. Students should be encouraged to try this. They will enjoy this activity and understand the concept better. Generally, when these concepts are taught to the students by drawing the diagram on the board, mostly students get confused about how the movements of the sun, the earth, and the moon result in these phases. They mug up this thing without understanding and visualizing. We have used a simple collection of materials which are cost effective and can be reused. The biggest advantage of this activity is that it makes our lesson more lively. There are more amazing activities for this topic that are listed in the lesson plan. The link for the lesson plan is given in the description box. Hope you like this video. Thank you for watching.